Welcome to the Interchange video. This is part of the car hire training series. Interchange began in 1886. Car service and car hire rules in AAR Circular OT10 define interchange in Car Service Rule 7 and Car Hire Rule 9. In this video, we'll look at where interchange fits in the car hire data flow, how to find the OT circulars, how interchange is defined and explained, and review interchange types and reporting. Interchange reporting is part of the car movement process. Interchanges are stored in the event repository, or ER. This process on the left side of the data flow was introduced in the overview video that is part of the car hire training series. This is where car movements are reported. Interchange and event reporting starts the process of determining car hire liability and drives everything else pertaining to car hire. It is important for railroads to strive for timely and accurate reporting. Carriers report interchanges and car movement events to Railinc through the train reporting system. AAR Circular OT10 and other circulars are published at railinc.com under Resources. No special authorization is required to reach these circulars. Go directly to this link or click the Resources button, then click the AAR Operating Transportation OT Circulars link at the top of the page. This opens a list of the AAR circulars in numeric order. Find OT10 and click on the link. This circular is updated monthly. An interchange is the exchange of rail cars between carriers. Car Service Rule 7 identifies three criteria for successful interchange. Number one, cars must be placed on the agreed upon interchange track. The locations of the interchange track is station specific. Carriers review local operations and agree on the best way to accomplish the interchange and agree on a track or tracks to be used. Number two, cars are preceded or accompanied by the necessary data for forwarding. Since the exchange of data is electronic, the cars are almost always preceded by the forwarding information. And number three, cars are accepted by the receiving carrier. Many carriers now use Interline Service Agreements, or ISAs, or Interchange Service Agreements to formalize interchange procedures. The Interchange Service Agreement is a binding agreement between two railroads for interchange, which spells out time and place of interchange. There is generally a variance that is allowed. The Interline Service Agreement is like the Interchange Service Agreement, but this agreement is non-binding. When interchange points are registered with Railinc, the carriers must designate the type of interchange to be accomplished. There are several types of interchange. Three of the most frequently used are normal, revenue, and operating. The most frequently registered type of interchange is at a normal interchange point, where cars are physically exchanged and revenue is divided based on the interchange. At a revenue-only interchange point, cars are not physically exchanged, but revenue is divided as though the cars were exchanged. Sometimes carriers find it advantageous to consolidate physical interchange points. Freight contracts, however, specify revenue divisions based on specific physical interchange points. In these cases, the carriers can agree to consolidate the physical interchange points, but still divide revenue as required in the freight contract, and a revenue-only interchange point can be registered. At an operating-only interchange point, cars are physically exchanged, but revenue is not divided. This is the opposite of the revenue-only interchange. Carriers may find it advantageous to exchange cars at a new point. However, the freight contracts require revenue division over another interchange point. An operating-only interchange can be registered to accommodate these situations. Carriers should report interchanges through the Train 2 system. The Liability Continuity System, or LCS, determines the official interchange date and time for car hire calculation purposes. The rules LCS uses to decide on the official date and time are intentionally skewed to favor a reporting carrier over a non-reporting carrier. We'll look at this in more detail later in this video. Within the Train 2 system, Train 01 and Train 10 messages are used to report interchange information. All of the message codes and types can be found in the Train 2 manual. Two special kinds of interchange can be reported using a Train 31 message. Train 31 Type A can be used to report a haulage interchange. Haulage agreements usually alter which carrier is responsible for car hire. Haulage will be covered in more detail later in this video. A Train 31 Type 5 can be used to report a liability acceptance message. A liability acceptance message allows a carrier to accept liability for a car, though LCS has assigned car hire liability to another carrier. These messages are comparatively rare. Reporting liability acceptance messages can also be accomplished through CAS by creating a LAM. Even though there are common carriers, there is nothing common about car hire accounting, and thus we have special types of interchange agreements. All of these special arrangements are bilateral, which means that both carriers must agree to the implementation. One of these arrangements is one-road reporting. One-road reporting allows one carrier to report all interchange activity at one location. In one-road reporting situations, only the interchanges reported by the designated reporting carrier are considered by LCS. One-road reporting interchanges may be made when one carrier's reports are considered to be more accurate than the other's. This was much more popular when interchange reporting involved significant clerical resources. However, now that reports can be generated electronically, one-road reporting relationships have become less popular. A second special interchange arrangement is a delivery-only agreement. In this situation, the deliveries reported by each carrier are used in the LCS analysis. Delivery-only arrangements are usually implemented where carriers have significantly different views of the interchange transaction. When only deliveries are considered, each carrier's view is considered half the time. When LCS analyzes the events, only deliveries are included. The delivery, in effect, becomes the official interchange transaction for car hire calculation. A third special interchange arrangement is the suppressed interchange. In cases where a suppressed interchange is in effect, the interchange is completely ignored. Car hire remains in the account of the delivering carrier. Suppressed interchange is usually used when one carrier is paying car hire on behalf of another. For example, if a Class 1 carrier has agreed to pay car hire on behalf of a short line connection, the interchange between the two carriers may be registered as suppressed. LCS ignores all interchange reported at a location registered as suppressed. Car hire remains with the delivering carrier until another interchange is reported. Since events are not masked, the car owner can see the movements of the car. A final special kind of interchange is a haulage interchange. Under a haulage agreement, one carrier typically agrees to act as agent for another. The carrier acting as agent is referred to as the haulage carrier. The carrier that hired the agent is referred to as the haulage rights carrier. Typically, the haulage rights carrier pays car hire while the haulage carrier handles the car and haulage interchange is suppressed. All movement activity reported by the haulage carrier is masked, so that it appears that the haulage rights carrier made the reports. When there is a haulage agreement put in place, the tables need to be properly set up with Railinc, and both parties need to have signed agreements in place prior to any car movements being done. Because the events are masked, the car owner does not see the events on the haulage carrier. The cars are shown on the line of the haulage rights carrier. Once the haulage interchange has been accomplished, there are three ways to end the haulage. Either the next regular interchange will end the haulage, or two changes in load empty status will end the haulage, or The haulage will end after 60 days. That wraps up this overview on Interchange. For more details about haulage, listen to the haulage video that is part of the Car Hire Training Series. Contact us for more information.